first time in Malaysia, how special it was for you to be appointed as new head coach here?
Of course, my first time in Malaysia, and yeah, what can I say? I was totally surprised at this time when Michael called me, and it was a very, very fast decision because I like the Malaysian style. I like the Asian style. 10 years ago, I stayed in Japan, and in this time start my love for Asia.
Okay, you left your country, your hometown to be here. How do you feel? How your emotion?
Nice. For me, it's not the biggest problem to leave Germany. Yeah, because I know and I can go back. Now I'm here, and I don't think about Germany. In this moment, I think about my job. I want to start to work with the team, and then everything will be fine.
Okay, Coach. How do you describe this club and where it is now?
I heard a lot of things about Selangor. I know the club earns a lot of titles in the past, yeah. But I think that's the past. You know, we have to know that. Yeah, we have to know that. But it's not a good way to do all the tradition in our backpack. Yeah, and then we have all the days we have our backpack with the tradition inside. Then we go out to the pitch. Then we have 20 kilos more. That's not good. We have to know everything about the club, but if we go for playing, then we have to concentrate it for our game, for our job.
Okay. Some of the fans might wonder, might expect you did not have much experience in Malaysia. What do you say about that? How will you convince them?
Yeah, the best way to convince all the people around the club is to win games, for sure. Yeah, to win games. Yeah, in the last weeks the team started, for my impression, a good way. Yeah, I will continue with my stuff this way. I will improve this way, and then I'm totally sure that we have a good time together.
Okay, our technical director Michael himself believed that you are the right candidate for this job. Why do you think he say like that?
Yeah, because he's an intelligent man. Eh? No. When I went from East Germany to West Germany a lot of years ago, I met him the first time. I think 30 years ago, and he was the coach, and I was the player. And then we learned from each other, and he knows my attitude. He knows my style to handle a team. He knows my personality, because I'm an open guy. You know, I'm an open guy for everybody. I'm an emotional guy. Yeah, that's my big skill, I think, and I can transform the emotions to the team. Yeah, I have a plan. We have to show the plan on the pitch together with the players. And but I have a good feeling. I have seen a lot of games of the first team. I have seen any games from the second team, and I think it's a good quality for sure.
We have a lot of talented and potential young players in our team. How do you see that?
That's right. I have seen some games from the second team. The second team has a good potential. For example, Arif, for example,
Sikri
and Afro. It's a good central defender. Also, Daniel as a striker is a good player. But we will see. Yeah? I don't want to give the young players too much pressure. They have to show me her performance. Don't be afraid of mistakes. Mistakes are a part of soccer. Yeah, that's sure. And but I will support them. But I will support the young players on the same way like all the other players.
You once been a professional football player back then in Germany and Bundesliga, but now you are a manager. So how do you see the importance between manager and players?
Oh, that's a, the do you mean the difference?
Mean the importance of good relationship between players and manager.
Yeah, but that's a good question, because the relationship between a manager and or the coach and the players, it's important, you know. But once have to be clear, the manager is the boss. Yeah, we can discuss about everything, but the last decision will I have. It's normal, but it's no problem for me. If anybody has a good idea, come to me and tell me his idea, because we want to have or we want to be successful together, not only the team, not only the staff, not only the manager. We want to be successful all together, and I think that's a good feeling, that's a good attitude, and we should think about that.
Okay, why do you choose to be a coach after you retire from being a professional football player?
Well, because I have two left hands, you know. I can do nothing. I can do nothing. I can be only a soccer coach. That's I have luck in my life that I can start my coaching career. Yeah, because all the other things, for example, make lamps or I don't know. No way. Yeah, but I had a good time in my first club, because I had the chance to be an assistant coach in the first Bundesliga. And at the same time, I was the head coach for the second team, and we played in the fourth league, and the first team played in the first league, and it was a good relationship between the both teams, and I have learned a lot of things of my boss, and then I translated to the second team the good things, and also my opinion I bring to the team. And now I am what I am.
Okay, being a coach is not an easy task. So what do you think your immediate challenge? Your first challenge?
First challenge, I'm looking forward to meet the team, you know. That's really I really can wait, or can't wait for this moment. But what is the importance challenge now? I have to know when the next season starts, you know. That means I can say we start on this date. It's not so it's very important, yeah. But also a challenge is now to have all players for the next season. Yeah, but we started this process very, very early. We are on a really good way for that, yeah. And then I need any information about the club, about my staff, about the players, because I told it before. I'm totally open. I want to know everything, and that will be the task for the next days.
The fans, they have been hungry for some time, and they will surely will follow your news. What is your message to them?
The fans are hungry for...
Hungry for success.
For success. Oh, me too. Yeah, me too. Hungry for success, of course. I want to win every weekend. I want to win with the team, with my staff, with all the members, with the supporters. We want to win games. Yeah, we want to win games. I'm totally hungry for success. And but we have to do that step by step, you know. I know a soccer a manager has not so much time in our business, yeah. But we need to improve the performance step by step. We have to improve the way. We have to improve small things, because small things can make sometimes the big difference. And yeah, and I will do everything. You know, I had now holidays since, I don't know, 10 months. I'm totally recovered. I'm in best shape. I cannot wait for start to work with the team.
Okay, so now we are playing in closed door stadium, but soon maybe we're going to have our fans back in stadium. So are you excited to meet the fans?
That's always a very important point, yeah, to meet the fans, to have a discuss or to talk to the fans, not only after winning games, but important is to talk with the fans if we have not a good situation. For example, after 10 wins, we will lose one time. I hope so. Yeah? I hope so. That means 11 games, 30 points. Oh, good average, you know. No, but that's very important. Defense have to know what we are doing. Defense have to understand our idea. Defense have to have a feeling that we know that they are always behind us. And I think that's a good relationship between the club, the team, manager, and the supporters. It's a very important point.
Okay, Coach, I think that's all. Thank you and welcome on board, Coach.
Thank you very much.